In this video, I am going to give you the idea about the IUPAC nomenclature of unbranched simple alkene. Let me draw the molecule like that. Now here, this molecule is in bond line formula. So in generally bond line formula, we do not represent the carbons as well as the hydrogens. So all these corners are the actually carbons, and the important part in giving the IUPAC nomenclature is to give the numbering to these carbon atoms. So here we can start the numbering to these carbon atoms from left hand side towards the right hand side, as well as from right hand side towards the left hand side. So let us start from left hand side. So this is carbon number 1, 2, 3, 4 and 5. Before giving the IUPAC name, let me tell you about the prefixes used in unbranched alkane. So if you have the total number of carbon atom 1, so your prefix will be meth, and it will end up with the ane as a suffix. Generally in alkane, ane is the suffix used in all the alkane compounds. If you have the total number of carbon atoms 2, then the prefix will be eth. For 3, it is prop. For 4, it is bute. For 5, it is pent. For 6, it is hex. 7, hept. For 8, it is oct. For 9, none. 10, it is dec. And the suffix is common as ane. So IUPAC name of the molecule which contain total number of carbon atoms 10, it will be decane. So up to 10, actually it is included in undergraduate level. But also we can give the prefix names to the molecule which contain greater than total number of carbon atoms 10. So for example, 11, the prefix generally used is undec. For 12, it is dodec. Dodec. Here in Spanish, do means 2 and dec means 10. So for 13, it is tridec. Tridec. For 14, it is tetradec. Tetradec. For 15, it is pentadec. So this is now coming like a traditional method. So it is for 16, it is hexadec. Hexadec. For 17, heptadec. Heptadec. For 18, octadec. Octadec. 19, nonadec. And for 20, it is icos, and it will end up with the suffix, so ane. So the IUPAC name of the molecule which contain total number of carbon atoms 20 will be icosane. Now let me give the name to this molecule. So we have total number of carbon atoms 5. So this is belongs to the prefix pent. So prefix will be pent and the suffix will be ane. So IUPAC name of this molecule become pentane. Now let us draw another molecule like that. Now here we can give the numbering to the each and every carbon atom like this. This is 1, 2, 3, 4, 5, 6, 7. Now here we have 7 carbon atoms. So this is the hept as a prefix. Hept as a prefix, and the ane is a suffix. So IUPAC name of this molecule will become heptane. Let us draw a little bit the longer chain like this. Yes, now we can give the numbering to each and every carbon atoms. So this is carbon number 1, 2, 3, 4, 5, 6, 7, 8, 9, and 10. Now when we are giving the IUPAC name, so we must know the total number of carbon atoms. So here we have 10 carbon atoms in this molecule. So prefix will be dec and the suffix will be ane. So the IUPAC name of this molecule will become decane.